9-7-4, a bit more for 9-2.
I'm going downtown. Hey, ain't nothing you can tell me that I don't already know. Oh, yeah. Been around the block a few times, seen it all before. Yeah. I know people in high places, like the club in the penthouse suite. Downtown street tonight. I'm going downtown. Get down. Tonight I'm going downtown. I'm going downtown. Get down. Yeah. I'm a old dog, but I got new tricks. Working hard from 8 to 6. Just watch how I get my kicks tonight. I'm going downtown.
It's not
working uptown, hustle for cash just to make some gas money. Stay been thinking how to make some fast money. All the things people do just to make ends meet. Find them new ways every day in the downtown street. Tonight I'm going downtown, I'm going downtown, get down. Tonight I'm going downtown, I'm going downtown, get down, yeah. See, I'm a old dog, but I got some new tricks. Working hard from 8 to 6. Now just watch me, you know how I get my kicks. Tonight I'm going downtown. Won't you tell me where we're going now? Won't you tell me where we're going now? Won't you tell me where we're going now? Are we going downtown? I'm gonna call my friends, we're gonna go out, have some fun. Yeah. Let it be all surprises, do something we never done. Yeah. Make some new memories and make the blues up as it comes. Yeah. And it ain't over until the morning sun. Tonight I'm going downtown, I'm going downtown, get down.
Hey, yo, man, come on. Oh, what's up? Oh, what's up? grab. Oh, where's yours?
Yeah, where's mine?
Vander, over there.
Oh, dude, just look at me. Look.
We are live.
Hey, that's me. Hey, everybody. Welcome freaking back. I know it's been a long waited journey for us to make our comeback here. And we brought a guest today, so thank you so much for joining us today at the 40 Hour. My name is Korn. This is my partner in crime, Pat LaRock.
Hey.
Say hi. And our special guest today is of the illest villains, of Forever We Rock, of a national championship rocking, title holding person, guy we've known for 15 years, grew up with. This is Whacko. A.K.A.
The Whackness.
The Whackness. We welcome him to our podcast today. So, but our most important co-host today is the 40 Hour Brand Beers. We brewed this from traditional San Franciscan monks.
Yeah, don't mind the... I don't know what this
oh,
is.
Oh, no. This yeah, we're this reusing the bottle because...
We recycle.
Because as San Franciscans, one must... recycle, reduce, and reuse.
Close the loop.
So
we keep it real.
Yeah. So, but these are totally brewed from ancient San Franciscan monks using ancient formulas, using only the best hops and barley and malt.
Your voice didn't crack when you said that. That's awesome.
Bruh, that's it.
I'm like leaning in like this.
Anyways, hold on.
Hey guys.
Let's unleash the power first. All right, okay, you guys. Okay. Cheers.
Cheers.
Welcome.
Welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
And we're here. You guys.
I need this.
All right.
There we go. Cheers, everyone. Cheers. Well, we are
for those following along, first sips.
First sips. Oh, no. No. I've taken an oath not to drink alcohol for a month, except for today.
Because today's a holiday, isn't it?
Because I'm in...
April Fool's!
It is.
Oh, it is April Fool's. Fuck.
Yeah. So we really started this 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Really?
Just kidding.
Again.
April so anyways, again. I guess we can start off with a little bit about introducing our buddy here, Whacko. He is someone we've known for 15 years or so, since the beginning of high school. We dance together. We are all part of the only...
But hold on, when we say
the
dance...
The realest.
Oh, wait, illest. I gotta take my shirt off, but...
Whoa.
That's not...
Whoa, let's...
Sorry.
All right. It's not that kind of podcast.
What he meant was...
We're talking about dancing.
We're talking about dancing like...
Hey, that's the type of dance.
Whoa.
Pony.
I'm just saying, don't be ashamed. That's
oh,
you.
Pony.
Yeah.
No. Jamsky, bro.
That's
anywho.
Anyways, okay.
So this is Whacko. He represents a few crews, and he is, if you are from the dance community, you will know that Whacko is a top rock champ. Shit, man, like the credentials are endless.
Top rocking.
Rock dance. Fucking...
I just rock, man.
He just rocks,
he
man.
He just rocks.
He just rocks, man. Give us some of your credentials, dude. Like, let us know. Let the people know.
Hit them with the resume.
Yeah, hit them with the resume.
Hit them with the resume.
Okay.
The rocksome.
Been flying myself out since 07. Let's see. One... Zulu Throwdown in San Diego. Zulu Throwdown in Portland. That was 2007, 2008. 2009, won a bunch of local stuff. Piedmont Drop. But 2011, flash forward, that's when I made my international trek to Taiwan. I battled Born and Why Not in both the Top Rock.
Born and Why Not. You guys know those names.
Yeah. 22 Hours.
He beat him.
You've seen those guys. That's
he
the thing.
Beat
those guys, yep.
You've seen
check
them.
YouTube.
Even if you don't know that you've seen them,
you've seen them.
You've like in commercials.
They're probably
movies.
On some fucking Mazda commercial or some shit.
They're
like zoom,
some,
zoom. They're
probably
dancing in the background.
They're probably on some Microsoft commercial. They're on some Microsoft commercial in the office.
With Cloud.
Yes.
With Cloud. Oh, with Cloud. Yeah, absolutely. Cloud is everywhere, dude.
Shakira, the list goes on.
Yeah.
But yeah, I won the same year I won Culture Shock, went to IBE for the first time, and actually...
What's IBE to the non-dancers?
To the non-dance folk out there, IBE stands for International Breakdance
Event. Where's it located?
Well, the first...
Internationally, that's where.
Yeah. Herlene.
Herlene.
It's 3 hours away.
Is that when you go like this?
Yeah, Herlene. yeah, been to Taiwan now 4 times. Did a tour out in Japan, the bucket list trip, dance trip. Yeah, that was dope. I just won Floor Wars. Those are 2-on-2 Top Rock. I entered that with the homie Eddie Styles from Rock So Fresh.
Nice. Is that the Denmark jam?
That was in Denmark where I got treated like a drug dealer.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
I'm sorry, what? You got treated like a what?
Oh, I was going to save this for later, but yeah.
We can save it for later. He got treated like a drug dealer because he was trying to sell some drugs. He was like, hey, you guys want to buy some marijuanas?
It's like, you're here for a day. Yeah, I'll save it for later.
Save it for later.
Anyways, I mean, I think it'd be good if we gave a little quick, super, super quick breakdown of just the crew in general, right? Just us, how we got together, right?
Yeah. I mean,
it was like out of high school, early college for me. We all joined the same crew.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Pretty much. And now we have Thanksgiving parties and this other
dinner parties.
Dinner parties.
Shit, man.
So, I mean, you know, shout out to the rest of the Illest Villains crew.
The Illest Villains crew.
Watching.
Hello.
We're not watching.
Or listening.
Don't close the cap, dude. Give me the cap.
No closing
of
the cap.
Sorry. I haven't been here in like 3 years. So.
There you go.
I'll clean that up later.
Anyways, so Vander, can you kind of give us a brief description and of how you got into rocking, top rocking?
Oh wow, you used my government name. I'm so used to Whacko.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's cool. Wait, Whacko's not your government name?
not the one he's officially
known by. Well, you guys know like. I still break. Most cats put me in this category, but there was a point where I injured my wrist really bad, and I couldn't like do footwork for a while, and so I almost quit dancing. But D-Rock from Renegades was like, "Nah,
shout
man."
Renegades
like,
crew.
He was like, "Yo, bro, just because you can't rock down the floor, you know, doesn't mean you can't stop rocking on top." So I just spent a long time just figuring out how to still be a threat without having to go down to the ground while mm-hmm. I was injured. And so I just put a lot of like my emphasis in energy into top rock. And then Bug Eye Bandit, another mentor.
That guy's still killing it, man.
He's always been
a character, man. He's awesome. Shout out to Bug Eye Bandit, San Diego, California.
Hound dog truckers.
I see you skating on Facebook.
Yo.
You and your kids that look exactly like you.
His kids look exactly like him.
Danny, you have come back 2 times, just
dude.
So you know.
Forever young,
forever rock. But yeah, see what I did there? Like,
you gotta make a clever one for Hill's Villains now.
All right.
I don't know, man.
Well, I got one for that later. But
Oh yeah, he got a little thirsty from the speech.
Hooked up with Danny at the Berkeley practices, and at this point, Danny was segueing out of break-in and getting more into rock dance. So he got tight with King Up Rock. He made the Mecca to New York several times, and he came back and basically he was looking for a sparring partner because I was like, "Yo, I want to learn how to rock."
Yep.
And he was like, "You're not ready."
He said, "You ain't ready."
So, before we go down this path, let's kind of tell the people
what
rocking is compared to, like, because everybody knows fucking b-boying, right?
Right.
Everybody's fucking cousin was a b-boy in high school and shit.
Or dad or mom. Like, I used to do the word.
I knew how to T-flare back in the day.
It's coming back.
I can do gyros. What?
Gyros?
The fuck is that? Well, anyways,
what are gyros?
Anyway,
you mean like
that thing that you eat?
Yeah.
Like I thought those were euros.
Like you're saying
no,
wrong.
But for because rocking is its own separate dance, its own fucking history, background, culture. But it all came from, you know, same people ish. But give us a quick, you know, 40-second breakdown of what rocking is.
Okay, rocking is a dance that comes before breaking, before hip hop and all that was even really given a name. So, talking to a lot of OG dudes from like the mid to late 60s, that was a dance that dudes did was rock. You rocked, okay? A lot of outlaw bikers can rock. So, a lot of the culture that we have in hip hop comes from like that outlaw slash gang culture, like rocking the vest, the top rockers, the bottom rockers, even the terminology that I'm throwing out. But it's a 1-on-1 confrontational dance. You dance the whole song. It's about humiliating your opponent. And the first one that stops basically loses. So,
look up
Whacko, rocking on YouTube, and then you'll see kind of what it's all about. And you'll see why he's one of the greats, if not the greatest right now, right, man? Who's got more titles than you?
We might have the best in the world right there.
This is a world champion at something, you guys.
Humble world champion.
Humble world champion, same crew, too.
Same crew.
I'm sitting here drinking beer, doing some basement-ass podcast, this dude's winning world championships. But same crew, though, so we're on, like, pretty much the same level.
So, I mean, that means we're champions, too, right?
We are, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Absolutely. Okay. Championship podcasters. Yeah.
See, I kind of wanted to say it.
You guys
are... No. You're justified. You're justified in that.
I'm just saying,
totes.
We're all champions. one of us wins. We all win.
But it's like, it ain't no fun unless the homies can hang, right?
Yeah. We hang out too much together, you guys.
That's too
much. Okay. Whacko, describe your style. Like, what do you find? Like,
yeah, why do you smoke the rest of the world?
Yes.
Why?
Give us the secret sauce.
Why are you smoking all these whack ass Denmark cats and these stupid imitation ass cats from Ill Villains
who just celebrated their 3-year anniversary last year?
Wow, that's cute.
Guess what? We've been around since 2001.
That means
that's
you can just start walking now.
Oh shit!
I mean. You'll see me in the summer, but my style comes from I'm really into my culture, like mm-hmm. you know, Harlem Renaissance.
I was gonna say traditional Celtic.
Right. We'll give it away. My mustache, beard. You know? It's like, you sure you're not Thai? The Nicholas Brothers, Whitey Lindy Hoppers, Soul Train. I really just try to embrace my culture and put that in my dance because talking to Track 2, he was like, yo, you know, your people are the architects of this hip hop thing. And, you know, New Yorkers like talk with their hands, you know.
I love talking with my hands.
So he was like, never forget that. And so when he told me that way back when, that just was like, okay, so. My thing is, nothing's rehearsed. I literally just try to go off. So I listen to the music, and it dictates what I do. So I think that makes me more unpredictable. And I don't karaoke songs, which I think a lot of people, and that's been the topic that's been coming up. But I think a lot of people they know Just Begun.
Too close to the ledge.
Right.
I get it. You're falling. Yeah. You're almost going to fall.
Oh, the ledge. The ledge is back there.
I got it.
I said that's...
Nothing's wrong with karaoke, though. I love karaoke.
But that's like stuff you
but
do...
But not if you're going to try to battle somebody.
Stuff you do when you're drunk and you're having fun.
Exactly.
Right? Like, I mean, who doesn't like the karaoke gin and juice?
Right.
Oh, shit.
Don't do it right now. Okay. There's
another time.
No, yeah. But anyways, Ven.
Are you guys sure?
So you don't karaoke the songs?
No, in the beginning, like I was whack, you know, and the thing is, like, I just listen, and I got into a point where I sit and listen, and I hear songs. Yeah, with rocking, that really opened me up because I know how long songs are. Like, you know, Give It Up, Turn Loose. That's like, you know, a 6-minute song. Like, Just Begun is 3:42. But I'm
really?
Not sitting.
I didn't
down.
Realize how short that song was.
Exactly. Yeah, well, yeah, because it's a speed.
Because as a b-boy, you get
right.
You get, you know, well, you get a, your yeah. round in.
You
it's
get
not,
your round is typically. It feels like a minute, but it's typically only like 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Right. Like, depending on how much like energy you're putting in that round, right. Like you know, you'd be like Tim the Pit who dances like 5 million miles an hour, or a guy like K Mel who's gonna be like on top for like forever, and then he's just gonna do a crazy like one combo. You know,
some footwork. Hollowback.
Right.
Halo Freeze.
Do they still call it Hollowbacks?
I don't think people like do Hollowbacks anymore. Like,
they don't do it, but
you know, from when
K-Mel
we're
will still do it though. K-Mel is still a fucking stud.
You know
that
who,
dude's a monster,
you know,
man.
He's gonna get mad at me. But you know who always tried to have Hollowbacks, but never could quite get it? Dre Boogie. Sorry.
Oh my bad.
And the only reason that he did.
Yo,
was,
you know what's funny? Wait, he used to go like this. He used to go handstand and go tuck his head in. And then that's it. Nothing else in the it goes hollow back, tuck his head in, and then his legs go like this.
I'm pretty sure it's hard though.
No, yeah, because
you know.
No,
like,
yeah, yeah. I have horrible
like,
shoulder flexibility.
Like, I couldn't do it. Could you do it?
I could do regular hollow backs, not invert a hollow back. But
oh yeah, and then the inverts.
Oh,
yeah,
God.
Yeah. I could never do it well, but because I had really bad shoulder flexibility.
So like a hollow back is basically like a handstand, but then you're like leaning.
Your back is hollowed out.
You're
half
back,
moon shape. Type.
It's almost like you're doing a
bridge. Drop your leg. Invert hollow back is when you look like this.
Yeah.
Like you look like a check mark.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking hey, man. Look at us talking about dancing like we used to do it and shit.
it's still here, man. Never stop.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Like, I feel like...
I'm retired.
I always talk to Pat about how dancing has just absolutely, like, fucking changed everything. Like, the way I look at shit.
Oh, man,
it's kind of like...
That's real.
It's super true. Because, I mean, it can be with anything. Like, just for us, it's b-boying and hip-hop. But for other people, it could be whatever. It could be playing in a rock band. It could be whatever. Because it exposes you to shit. You're just like, oh, okay. So here's some experts at something I'm interested in.
Right.
And here are some masters at it. And it's for hip-hop and for b-boying, like, the masters are still alive.
Yep.
The Jesus of hip-hop still lives in New York. He's just walking around. It's like, yo, I'm the Jesus of hip-hop. Right?
Watch out. I want to get that donut real quick.
It's like, like, no, but can I get a dollar, though? Like, I got to catch the bus back.
I mean, that's
it's like, whoa, shit.
That's fucked up, right? Like, this,
it is. Absolutely.
The culture that he's birthed.
Bless you.
Excuse me.
He was going to make such a poignant fucking statement, and he just had to fucking burp in the middle of it.
Hey, man, that's just your soul trying to escape. That's all good.
I forgot what I was going to say. But I'll go with the second thing that I thought of. When I was doing my research for this episode, because I actually do research and shit, like I was, Korn does no.
Pat just messaged me in the day. Like,
no.
What do you think about this? I'm like,
yeah.
It's funny because like I'm the one that came to him. Was like, let's do a podcast. He's like,
and I'm
okay,
the one putting in
whatever. I was like, yeah, just hang out. We'll just talk. And now he's just like, yo, I'm about to do these animations. I'm about to do these things. Blah blah blah.
Check out this cut.
I'm like, yo, man, you earned yourself a producer credit. Boom. Wait. Boom.
Okay, so anyways, while doing my research
mm-hmm.
on this, like, I was watching some of your battles, like...
Oh, my battles.
Yeah, your battles. Like, when you won the Renegades anniversary, and...
Look it up. Whacko wins Renegades anniversary.
I have a story with that,
When you won Floor Wars, and, for me, when I was watching it, I kind of wanted to start dancing again.
Dude.
Like, I was like, I, you know, like, it was weird, because, like, I was on my lunch break, so I work on my lunch break. But like, if you looked underneath the table and looked at my feet, they were dancing. But like, that's a feeling I get whenever I like watch you dance. Like, you make me want to get up and start like grooving again.
Damn.
You
because
know what I mean? So like,
because
I mean,
honestly, like something that's really cool about rocking in
mm-hmm.
general, it's kind of like because you have the whole song, right? You have the whole song.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like you have to squeeze a bunch of your moves into one spurt, you know?
Right.
Like rocking, you're like, okay, I have this whole song to just build my story. Mm-hmm. I'm going to build it up. I'm going to go, oh, okay, so I'm going to take this approach where, because you know what? You're not reacting like I'm reacting. So, oh, I know this song so well that I know that I'm going to come in. I'm going to fucking slash you up. I'm going to do this. I'm going to dismember you. And like all these things you can think of because you have a whole song to do it. Versus b-boying, where it's like kind of like,
expected
all right,
to go down.
I got my top rock, like even Ken Swift said, like, so what's top rock? What's top rock is the shit you do before you go down on the floor,
mm-hmm.
you know? So,
yeah.
But if the shit you do before you go down on the floor is your a fucking whole song, you got a whole story to tell there. Versus b-boying, where it's kind of like, here's
right.
the intro, here's the
I
middle
feel
like of it.
B-boying
here's
is more
of
an
it,
essay,
you know?
Right? Like b-boying is more of an essay where. Whereas like rocking is more of like a free form like haiku. Just kidding, no poem. tough.
Well, b-boying is, yeah, it's like an essay. It's like a, it's more concentrated. It's kind of like, you can tell, like, rocking definitely came before b-boying, you know what I mean? Like, it was one of those things where it's kind of like, oh, this is where I can, and then somebody just, like, fuck it, I'm going on the floor. I'm going to fucking do this on the fucking floor.
Well, I like what Pat's saying. I think either way, you're telling a story, because even my early infancy stages when I started, someone told me, it was like, okay, when you do your top rock, you're telling everybody who you are.
Yeah.
And so years later when I started teaching, like I teach weekly, and in my workshops,
what do you teach?
Like, I teach Top Rock Tuesday.
Where?
At City Dance.
In San Francisco.
City Dance, San Francisco, Top Rock Tuesdays.
8:30.
Google it, because you got a Google machine. I know it because you're watching this right now.
Exactly.
Boom.
And it is one of the last places in the city where you can probably learn this art form.
From a champion. A world champion.
Yes.
Two-time. IB. Two-time.
Two-time. Two-time.
We're going to take commission for that. Yeah. So, anyway.
Because, you know, we're champions,
yo, tell,
too.
Tell
we're
Whacko.
Champions too. We're champions, too.
Tell Whacko the 40-hour sent you, and we get a little kickback. Thank you.
Excuse me. Can you sit us while we're champions?
We're champions, too.
Okay.
Yay! Oh, my god.
Well, welcome to Denny's. Yeah, that's right. I want the table near the window. All right, hook it up. But, no, I think... you're telling a story, and like what I try to plant a seed is like, what's your intent? You know, I can be just as powerful as a ruin or B-Boy Casper or Kid David. You know, all those guys are known for the musicality, and I never really like tripped over that. I mean, honestly, like you guys were first cast to like compliment me on my dance, and I'm still weirded out by that. Like, you know, Pat, we had a heart-to-heart, like, a while ago, and, you know, because I was like, I don't consider myself a B-boy, and you're like, dude, wait, I've seen you smoke guys without having to go to the floor, so what does that say about you?
Well, yeah, I mean, I feel like more so than others, like, I mean, I don't have much credibility to my name, but...
None. Absolutely oh,
fucking
none.
Dick.
You said it. But, I've been trying to say
but
it so long.
Who used to, but I feel like b-boying is much more of a mentality versus just actually being like the dancing portion of it, right? Mm. Like if you understand the top, you understand the footwork, if you understand the power, you understand the style, you understand the freezes, you understand all the aspects, and you did your history, you did your homework, and you understand all those pieces, even if you step up and you're whack, you're still a b-boy to me.
Yeah.
Because you understood. You did your fucking homework. Like, look, not everybody is as physically, like, you know, able or gifted or capable or just in general, just not there.
Like, you know,
but if your mentality is there, I feel like that's the most important part of being a b-boy. It's like, I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna do my fucking tops. I want everybody to know I'm about to fucking come in. If you come in into a circle and you can't see my face, but you see me moving, so there's Corn.
Boom. Yeah, I mean,
I see Corn breaking right there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then you hit the floor and you do your shit, even if it's whack. Like, if you have the mentality and you've done your homework and you paid your dues in terms of just interacting with the community, like, that's a b-boy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like, because I think we all know someone that goes like, oh, yeah, I used to do that.
Yeah.
Like, know so many? Everybody knows somebody.
But here's the thing. It's like,
that's how I know you're not a b-boy. Because you used to break dance.
But the thing is like, they left it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because when they say like, oh yeah, I used to do it, and like, but it's like, but you...
And they probably also appropriated a bunch of other fucking, like,
subcultures.
Things, you know what I mean? Like,
you know, like,
it's so, like, oh, I also used to DJ.
And I used to street race.
I used to skateboard.
That's great. Tell me more
about
that.
And honestly, like, there's nothing wrong with doing a bunch of different cool shit.
If
because
you really did
it's cool shit. All those things are cool
but
as fuck.
But you had to have really...
But, you know what I mean? Like, you gotta learn your history. You gotta learn the culture. You got
Liam Neeson.
You got Liam Neeson.
Pretty much. But yeah, like, I mean, the thing is, anyone that puts in work and is there, like, you know, I would call them a B-boy or a B-girl. Not everyone can
a
be
a B-gal.
Not everyone can be. Not everyone.
Is that gonna catch on? No,
because you have no credibility.
Fuck you.
But anyways, what I'm trying to say. Here's what I'm trying to say. My point is that anyone that puts in work can be a B boy or a B girl. Not everyone can be champions like us.
Yeah.
Yes.
Woo!
We made it.
We're actually getting some hits on the chat to show some dance moves. I don't think there's enough room.
There's not enough room.
There just isn't going to happen. But
YouTube,
please,
YouTube Whacko.
Dude, Whacko. You can YouTube us too, but you're going to get some like 15-year-old footage of us fucking looking Asian as shit.
Well, remember when we saw Johnny Knoxville on our way to Alpha Fame?
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, let's tell that story. So Alpha Fame, when Alpha Fame first came out, what was that, 10 years ago?
Oh,
something
God,
like
that was like 2002.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, 2002.
That's when I graduated high school. Yeah.
And they did their first one in the city.
Oh, dude, yeah.
Underneath the freeway.
At Soma Arts.
Soma Arts. Yep.
Rest in peace. It's still around, but
it's still around, but it's all artsy and
but
shit.
But they don't. Yeah.
It's called Soma Arts.
It's not street. It's not street artsy.
There you go, because they like they blocked out all the graffiti. Yeah.
But
so.
Me, Whacko,
Mauricio,
and Mauricio Rockboy. He's in New York right now. Hello.
We're like, rest in peace.
Hey, rest in peace. He's alive.
He's alive.
We should point like this.
We're like, but we're all pointing up. We're like, wait. Yeah. There you go. Okay.
But, so we're driving through the hate because we're heading over to the jam, and fucking Mauricio goes, "There's Johnny Knoxville." I was like, "What?" That's when Jackass just first came out.
Yeah, it was birthing.
And I had fucking braces and shit. I was like, and I was driving because Whacko wasn't driving. Mauricio didn't have a car, so I'm sitting here driving like, "Hey, bro."
That's high school.
Like, you know what I mean? Yeah. In high school, you had to, you know, there's the guy who can drive. There's the guy who knows how to drive and doesn't have a car. Yeah, you know, you got those.
Yeah.
But I had a car and I could drive. So we fucking drive through the hate and Mauricio goes, "Johnny Knoxville." And we're like, "What the fuck?"
And I was like, "Oh shit, that is Johnny Knoxville." Yeah. Like, "Corn, pull over, bro."
I was like, "Oh fuck." So I pulled over in the McDonald's.
Oh, we crashed into each other.
oh shit, fuck. We pull over in the McDonald's in the hate, like at the very end by milk. And we get out. Johnny Knoxville sitting on the corner. He's sitting on the floor, just fucking big ass aviator shades on, with an iPod, like an old school iPod that like clicks and shit. You know what I mean? And he was sitting there just stoned as fuck. And we're like, "Hey Johnny, can we take a picture with you?" He's like, "Yeah." And we took a picture with him, and that's our whole story.
And then we went to the jam.
That's about it.
Did
we enter?
Yeah, we did. We did it. We entered the 3-on-3.
Oh, is that?
Oh no,
is it us three?
Yeah, it was me, you, Mauricio, and then we picked up two other, like, before we were, like, running the board.
This 3-on-3?
It was a 5-on-5.
We
had three, but we needed two, and he was like, these two Latin kids was like, "Yo, you need two?" We were like, sure, fuck it, why not? But then like, I remember, like, only, like, three of us went out, and then, because it was a timed battle. I hate timed battles.
Do
they still have that?
Well, Out for Fame?
No, timed battles.
Yes.
That's terrible.
It's... Depending on what coast you're in, or what
I mean,
city
this
you're
isn't
in.
Street Fighter where you have.
Yeah,
like,
it's like.
Yeah, but also like, you know how unorganized B-boy jams are, fucking.
Oh, don't do it. Do I?
Do I?
Do I? My word. But
Jackass.
Yeah, Jackass. But tell us your best dance story.
My best dance story.
You got hella serious.
Wow.
I was like, tell us.
I was like, I feel like you're like Joker from Batman and Bob.
Your best.
Bob.
Number one. Hey, you know what? I just watched that actually the other day. It's so good. It holds up.
So good.
Except for Batman killing everybody. But that's not. It, what
yo,
old
he's already
is new
doing
again.
It again.
Yeah, that's the Keaton, though. That's Keaton, though.
God.
Ooh, I got a live one here.
painting the statue.
I'm about to play that Prince song real quick.
Your best dance story.
My best dance story. That would probably have to be more recent. I have to because I'm Denmark. So Floor Wars 2016. It's a jam I've been trying to get to for a long time. Finally was like, "Yo, like Eddie, let's do the 2-on-2."
I'm
halfway through.
I'm
following at home. Halfway through. We're halfway through.
I'm pretty much more than halfway through.
Yeah, I'm being nice because I'm trying to sit. But so I got the time off work to fly out. My job. Even my boss was like, "Yo, you better come back like on winter." Okay.
Awesome.
I mean, goddamn. Yeah.
I was like, yes, boss. You know, yes queen, sir. You know. So got my flight. I was going from SFO to DC, DC to London, London to Denmark.
Brutal
didn't make
flights.
It. Yeah, didn't make it like that though. So flew from SFO to DC. We take off, and I'm knocked out. And then I'm like, wow, that was quick. We're already in London. Nope. We made an emergency landing.
Oh, fuck.
They couldn't
Why?
Stay. Apparently, the someone was up the landing gear. And we landed, and then we were basically doing donuts on the runway, and then
that's fucking brutal.
Then the pilots were like speaking their native tongue. It was like this Danish, and everyone's just like, what the hell is going on?
Speaking English. What's going on in my life?
I like Twilight Zone. So stewardess ran to the front. She was like, hey, they can hear you, we're sorry, this is your captain speaking. And it was like. Die Hard, perfect English. It's like, this is your captain speaking. Like,
we're doing donuts in the dry.
Yeah, no shit. So basically the flight got delayed, so they put me up in a hotel for a night. Whack. Then flew out first thing in the morning to London. Laura Uncton. Cloudy as fuck, couldn't see Jack, and then was stuck in London. So I lost 2 days off my trip.
Fuck.
I got to Denmark day of the event, and got to customs, you know, the usual spiel. They ask you, like, oh, welcome to, like, our country. How long are you going to be here? Where are you staying? You know. So I was like, you know, when do you leave? And they're like, oh, I leave tomorrow. And they're like, you're only here for a day? And I was like, yes. My flight got delayed. I lost 2 days off my trip. I'm not about to just go turn around. I said, I'm here for a dance event. I want to see your country. You know, the usual spiel. And they're like, okay. So the girl took my, like, passport, and it was like, you know, in Fifth Element, like, when they're, like, trying to fly out, it was just like, she just disappeared. And I'm like, okay. I was like, multi-pass. Corbin Dallas, multi-pass, you know.
And you were wearing a fucking...
Yeah, right, the...
Oh, wow. Oh! You're like, sir?
I was like,
this is very disturbing.
So...
This is very distracting, sir.
You're scaring families.
Then it turned to, like... What was it, 13 days later or 21 days later? I'm the only one at customs. I'm like looking around. I'm like,
oh, hell no. Were there like a bunch of bags just like,
dude,
off of the thing? And
hey,
you're like, what's wrong?
I'm like, hello.
Hello.
So,
28 days later.
28, guys.
Sorry, 28. Well, you know, we're dancers. I went to art school. I don't know. So, anyways, so the lady disappears. She has my passport. Another lady comes back. And she has a gun on her holster and a German Shepherd. And then another dude's with her and he has my passport. And they're like, sir, come with us. And I was just like, okay. They take me into a room. They interrogated me for about an hour. And the jam was starting in an hour. And they're like, why are you here? Like, I mean, it's kind of suspicious. You're only here for a day, sir. And I was like, I just told you guys like five different ways. Like, my flight got delayed. I'm here for a dance event. But they kept missing the dance event part.
Did you battle them?
And I wanted to. Like,
you just,
I
was like, just, could you go ahead and
I felt
up?
Like
it's just begun?
Right, yeah. Like, I felt like, what's this face from Mr. Society? You know, I'm just like, my hands are on the table.
Oh, my God.
You know, the room is spinning around.
Brutal.
You know. You know you're fucked up, bro, right? So, finally, this other dude comes in. And he sees my jacket. I'm wearing my Top Rock City jacket that I won from Top Rock City. Peace out, Wiggles. Why not? And he was like, oh, my friend, are you here for the dance events? My son's there now to dance. And
did you smoke his son?
Yeah, actually, I did. sorry, I got to keep it real. So he walked over, just stamped my passport, and I was out. And, like, Eddie was like, yo, like, text me. Like, he's like, well, Facebooking me because I don't have, like, international.
Yeah.
Like, what happened? I was
Wi-Fi
like,
actually.
Oh, stuck at customs. I might not come.
Oh my God.
I don't know. Went straight to the gym, signed up, and just, yeah, won.
Won the whole goddamn thing. All you kids fucking stretching beforehand, preparing, getting, like, with your game plan and shit. My boy stuck in customs up until minutes before the jam.
That's almost like Nate Diaz beating Conor McGregor on 2 weeks'
shit,
notice.
It is.
Right?
Just saying.
He showed up and just smoked saying. Everybody.
No, people forget that.
Plus, Eddie Styles is fucking dope, yeah. too. Eddie Styles is fucking super dope. God.
Plus the highlight.
Look up Eddie Styles, Forever We Rock. And, oh, no.
Rock So Fresh.
Rock So Fresh. I'm sorry. You're hitting the mic, bro.
Oh, sorry.
But he's also absolutely fucking fresh, dude. Like, that dude is so good.
So I see that we do have, like, a lot of people asking for Whacko to dance and show him move.
Wow.
But here's the thing. If you're good at something, never do it for free.
Ooh.
So take his workshop.
Or my class.
Or his class.
I'm actually getting ready to go on tour.
And you don't need to see Whacko dance. He'll teach you all the moves. There you go. Boom.
A boom. Also, just fucking Google it. You guys can be watching it.
Like, there's
all
two
over
windows.
YouTube, man. I mean, y'all hit Control T, start a new tab.
You can
YouTube.
Still listen.
I use the incognito tab.
Oh,
you know about that, right?
Oh, yeah, but that's not for just
sorry,
shit. That's
sorry.
That's private mode.
Gotcha. When you're at work and you're like,
oh, you
no,
mean
it's you don't do that at work.
You don't do that at work.
No, that's how you get arrested, dude. Not,
your only novices do that.
You know what incognito is for, right?
Yeah, I think we all know what incognito is
for. Watching Batman versus Superman.
Hello, Deadpool. It's on YouTube. I mean, it's on Facebook right now.
It's for porn.
You said it's for porn?
Yo. So, Pornhub, today.
Here we go.
So, today's April.
From being champs to this.
So, tell me,
Corn.
Today's April Fool's, and I didn't actually.
Oh, wait. I'm sorry. We have a question. Where is the workshop?
Oh.
Oh, where's my workshop?
Yes. Or where's your class?
My class is at, City Dance Ballet, Tuesdays, Top Rock Tuesdays, from 8:30 to 9:45.
Do you have the address?
Do you have a website?
No?
Hit me up on Facebook, Evander Whacko Hill.
That's
for
his government
details.
Name.
My government name. So. I'm probably going to forget it, but just follow the Whackness. I'm the Whackness on Instagram.
There you go.
Just Google is it. Just Googles it.
That's actually how I type.
It's like, Vander, stop sitting so low.
Stop saying my government.
Your posture's horrible.
I know. I'm like the Maxwell guy, the usual sir. Yes.
So what were you saying, Corn?
Oh, no. Today is April Fool's Day.
Pornhub.
And Pornhub did cornhub.com. So they did a bunch of fucking pictures of corn.
But like in like...
Not me. But corn on the cob.
Oh my God.
But like in erotic...
What's
like
your yeah. And it goes like... Plowing some corn.
It's like rah.
Hot young corn. And it's like, what?
Stop
the
talking
fuck?
About yourself, corn.
This is like a fat
this
is like,
verbal,
like a fat dude.
This is like verbal
like,
masturbation right now.
You know.
It's like a fat dude like eating like a big old like corn on the cob.
So it was corn.
Yes.
Okay, it was corn. Okay.
You could be a flat dude or a flat chick.
He said fat.
You said I heard flat. I heard flat.
I said flat.
Yeah.
Well,
Liam Neeson.
Anyways.
Oh my God.
I had a question for you, Whacko.
Yes.
So the Joker says, where do you come up with all those wonderful toys?
Ooh.
How do you come up with all your burns and your attacks? How do you come up with it? Like, what is the creative process like for you, Whacko?
I think we lightweight talked about this a long time ago in the good old cell space days.
We'll talk about that later.
Thank you.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Honestly, my inspirations are just everyday life and cartoons, or you know, when they're still around. Honestly, like in the moment, like for example, when I battled Born at a Culture Shock. Okay, his name's Born, so there's a you know, part in Give It Up, Turn Loose. There's like, you know, baby, you know, he's like, also I gave birth to Born, and then I was like, I raised him. And I was going to stop there where I was like, you know, I was suckling him, you know, feeding him. And then I was like, you know, I'm going to throw him up in the air. And then like in that moment, I was
so
like, you know
what?
I'm going to shoot the baby.
Except that part. You don't do that part.
So it's just kind of like how, you know, it's just a chain of events. It's like I get an idea and then I just keep running with it. And I just kind of see things like develop. So
Because for me, honestly, my objective whenever I dance is to have all eyes on me. I want the person that's exactly. across
well,
from me.
Well, narcissistic as fuck for yeah, wanting yeah. to dance, dude.
I mean, even when I come into a cypher, it's like, oh shit, Whacko.
You especially, fucking asshole. You look know? At fucking staring at me like I'm the only fucking one. Fucking dare you.
You are. Shit.
But no, I'm that guy that's at Bart. Like, you know, I can hear music or I'll see something. I see shapes. And movement when I hear a song. So when I hear like a drum like build up, I see my feet moving really fast. So my inspiration is like literally like, you know, just from all around me. So
awesome.
Yeah.
Well, you ever thought about playing music?
Actually, I can play the trombone.
Really? What the fuck?
First year. When I was at Reardon.
What the fuck?
Yeah. That's why I was
low. I had no idea.
You're yeah. stupid. You don't know your friends.
Well, I didn't know you fucking played trombone.
God.
Jesus!
That was
volume on?
Yes! See? When I'm yelling
the green
it goes
up!
I'm not. It doesn't do shit. Oh, I can hear it.
You're going deaf.
Anyway.
Your earphones are
anyway,
stupid.
My fucking earphones don't work.
You gotta get the Beats by Dre, bro.
I know, you don't. You have like a hat. You have a hat company.
Yeah.
You have a hat company using headphones.
Stick to making hats, y'all. I'm just saying. I'm
that actually
just
came
saying.
From a hat. So
that was like the freebie. It was like, you got this awesome hat. Now here's some okay, like headphones.
But anyways, so before you know, like while we're talking, you know, I wanted to get your opinion on. I did want to talk about cell space for a little bit.
Okay.
So why don't you tell everyone out there what cell space is? Oh, actually, we have a question.
Mm.
Whacko, where did you get your name?
Okay, how did I get my name?
And they hashtagged with Jocko. The hashtag game.
No, okay,
fun.
So...
But they're different users.
Okay, oh, but okay.
Whoever so that is, Anonymous 1005, you misspelled his name.
Yeah, it's W. It's the sound effect. So it's not W-A-C-K-O, because everyone knows in hip-hop...
No. They put a Q.
Oh, even better.
And you didn't
WHQ?
Even, but you didn't even put a U. You didn't even misspell it right. You didn't put a U after the Q.
Sorry to shame you, listener. Sorry to shame you.
You didn't have the QU.
Yo.
There's a Q and then there's a C. I'm
where
saying,
did you get your fucking
you
name,
get
brother?
Your name?
Where did
okay,
you get
so
your name?
Okay, so how did I get my name? It's actually it comes from a childhood nickname that I got growing up. Being a child of Fillmore and Michigan.
Wait. I thought your nickname growing up was N Sabaner.
Oh,
the first.
Shit. Oh,
damn!
Shit.
I see you.
I am apocalypse. Anyways, all right. Sorry. Get
okay,
back.
No, it's yeah. cool.
You fucking nerds.
Yeah. Come on.
We both.
You think we're gonna be serious all night? Wait, you think we're gonna be serious all night? Every 80s movie, someone takes off their glasses.
Jeff Goldblum, I'm looking at you.
Okay.
You're the king.
Scat king. All right. Okay, so how I got my name,
can't see.
When I started going to school in the Mission, especially, I was like the one like black kid with all my Latin homies, my Salvadoran, Mexican, Peruvian, whatever. And you know, the old Mission was hard, you know, so when
yeah.
we get into fights, I was like the one
yeah.
dude that had my boys
yeah.
back,
yeah.
you know, Everett, Mission High, I didn't care. And my boy Ricardo, they used to call me Psycho. They're like, damn, dude, you're fucking crazy whenever we fight, man, you know. And then my boy Ricardo was like, no, you're worse than a Psycho. You're like a fucking Whacko. Yeah, you're like a fucking Whacko, bro. And I was like, oh, wow, okay. And then so that just was the name that, that kind of stuck. And then, again, my early years of breaking, like, I always went for the, like, crazier move. So, like, the first move I ever learned was a suicide. Someone had described it to me. And they're like, oh, yeah, you know, Frosty Freeze. That's, you know, he made the...
Frosty Freeze.
You know,
rest in peace.
One of my inspirations. They're like, yo, like, that's the guy that, like...
He is, yeah, one of the original, he's goofy, cornball characters. Like,
and there's a picture
amazing,
of him.
Amazing.
When Dynamic and Rocksteady battled at Lincoln Center and National Geographic covered it, it's this picture of Frosty doing a suicide. And he's, like, literally, like, 10 feet in the air. It's like... Whoever took that picture was perfect. So I heard it and I saw that picture. I was like, oh, that's a suicide. So I just jumped up as high as I could when my boy was describing it to me.
Suicide.
And I did it on the street,
Jesus.
Like sidewalk.
Yeah.
And I got up and I was like, was that it? And they were like, yeah.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Are you okay? I'm like, yeah, I'm good. No. You know.
Good. Yeah. Fucking started learning the rest of the shit. Like, yeah. How do you tut?
You know, like, I'm going to learn those. Okay, you know, so I'm
like. Like, back in the day when, like, all breakers fucking learned how to like pop, too.
Yeah, that's like, you have to pop.
You got to learn how to pop. You got to learn how to lock.
Not pop lock, because they're two different
things. You don't say pop lock.
No, no.
You say, do you pop or lock?
Thank you. Taking the school path.
Do not. Oh.
What I did last night. But yeah, that's how I got my name. So my homie Ricardo, I went from, they used to call me payaso, which means clown in Spanish. So from a clown to psycho to wacko. So nice. They used to call me payaso. Because I was like the only black kid with all these Latin kids. And they're like, yo, payaso. And I'm like, would you speak fucking English, man? Like, no, because I was paranoid because like, no, you know, I'm in the mission and a lot of my friends would always speak Spanish around me. So you get paranoid when you hear someone speaking their native tongue, I'm like, are they making fun of me? Like,
yeah.
I didn't know.
Asking, yeah.
Are they saying, jump him?
Yeah, I'm like, I don't
know. I mean,
you know, so luckily I'm one of the most cultured African Americans you'll meet, and I got
take off
your
glasses. I like how this motherfucker put his elbow up and said,
I'm just saying.
One of the most
you gotta take off
fucking
your glasses
cultured.
Probably, you know. But that's you know.
That's not a hero.
I'm one of the most
everywhere.
But,
culture.
You know, don't take my word from it, you know.
Okay.
I rest on your face.
Whacko, so you have another question. Wow. Okay.
Well, wow.
I appreciate you for spelling his name right, first of all. second of all, do you watch... Oh, come on.
Dancing with the Stars.
Do you watch Dancing with the Stars, Whacko? He's too busy teaching people how to dance. I'll answer this one for him.
Oh, thanks.
Honestly, like...
He's no, too, I'll
as
say
far
this.
As Dancing with the Stars go, like, I feel like that's probably a show I'd totally watch, but I just... Don't
I say the watch. Earlier years, yeah, like, yeah. The earlier years, like, I think my favorite season was the year that Scary Spice was on there, because, like, I always love Scary Spice, plus she's hot, and Eddie Murphy, you're stupid for, like, not being with her.
Eddie Murphy's pretty stupid in general, like,
yeah, exactly.
He's a great stand-up comedian, he was great too, but he's not...
I'm just saying, you know, you guys banged, it was mutual, and she was like, okay, mutually I'm pregnant banged. With your kid, I don't care, I want to be with you, and he was like, no, that's not, no, you know.
That's good that they mutually banged.
And then she was like, okay, fine.
I mean, if you don't mutually bang someone, just call
Molly quips
it's called something else.
It's called rapé.
No, Molly quips with that show, though, is, one, they don't play, like, the actual original music, which is whack, and, I don't know. It's changed, but I don't really watch like a lot of the dance shows.
Well, because they have all those fucking. So you think you can dance?
Yeah,
and
it's like
my fucking
the
hair.
People that should God win never win. I'm like, yo, like Scary Spice won. Like, why didn't she win? You know, but Christy Yamaguchi won that year. She's from the Bay.
She's
pretty fly too. You know, I was all about the like, okay, Winter Olympics. Christy
You're
Yamaguchi.
About the Gooch.
Yep,
the Gooch.
Chrissy Yamaguchi.
What
oh,
the
fuck? My goodness.
Wow.
You put your nose
this is
in
a family. This is a family drinking show. How dare you?
A family drinking show. I don't care.
I don't care.
I make that shit work.
I make that shit work. Stupid. Cheers, my dears. If you guys are following along, I'm a below half label.
I'm.
Oh, everybody else is like.
Yeah.
Down
no,
to.
Me and Pat are probably going to kill this.
Yeah. I've been laughing too hard, you know?
Yeah,
like,
you're enjoying life.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I would be remiss, though, if we didn't talk about Cell Space.
Yes.
So,
let's talk about Cell Space.
Wacko, give them the rundown of Cell Space.
What is Cell
and
what
why
is
it's
Cell
important,
Space?
And why
first.
It's important.
Why is Cell Space
it was
important?
It was important.
Oh, it still is important.
Well, tell them what Cell Space is.
Cell
first.
Space is basically, like, one, that's how we like stayed fit in our dance life. But more importantly, Cell Space is the glue of the Bay. It started as just a couple casts teaching people how to like screen print, and then it blossomed
really?
Into this other thing of just it was a shared artist space. You had live-in artists that lived there, so that you know you paid your rent, but you'd also have like show there. And
you guys should watch this documentary.
It's pretty much the most San Francisco
Pat
thing you can LaRock. Fucking go.
Like, Cell Space, a retrospect?
The
actually,
most San Franciscan thing you can do, right?
Yeah,
it's a fucking building, and it's like, if you're an artist, you can fucking just show up and do whatever you want.
Yeah, it was a combination of, it started with Bug Eye Bandit and the Sisters of the Underground came together, and they found the space.
The homies.
Bug Eye Bandit actually officially taught the first Breaking 101.
From, I learned that.
and through Pat can attest.
The documentary I made.
And he taught the first class.
The documentary I made.
Tell you something about George.
So
okay?
Let me tell you about this documentary.
Tell you something about George. George is nitty. Okay. But yeah, Cell Space basically was home to like some of the best like artistic events ever
in San Francisco.
And San Francisco is a bunch of artists. It almost was
the headquarters.
Yeah,
almost.
It was the headquarters.
Besides Soma Arts back in the day.
Yeah.
Cell Space was where you can go and
weird. Do what you want.
Yeah, you could juggle.
Yep, you could do the circus shit. Burning Man people were there. We had the Aztec dancers who are like our resident cousins. So they were always before us. Not many people remember this. Only you guys can. But actually, there was two practice nights. So there was a Monday nights and Tuesdays. Mm-hmm. Tuesday was that obscure night where it's like they were kind of like they might hate, they might not.
Yeah.
Right. And it was the only place in the city where you only paid $1 to practice.
$1. And you know
what? And
extrapolated over 15 years, it only went up to $5.
Yeah.
Three.
And that was
And then if you didn't have $3, it's like, dude.
Yeah, so it
you're a jerk, which I usually was.
Yeah, there was that one point of the night we'd be like, hey guys, don't, you know, we're asking for $3 or whatever you have in your pocket. But because most places, when back in our YMCA days, I mean, we had to pay like $5. And if you were like a non-member, it was like $5. If you're a member, it was like $3 or something, like something whack like that. But initially, like Mighty Four, Out for Fame, some of the best B-boy jams were held at Cell Space, period. So look it up. The homie Pat LaRock.
It was just a really cool spot. It was just, it kind of epitomizes San Francisco. And I think we talked about it in this show before. It just really epitomizes San Francisco because it was one of those places where it's like, I don't know what this place is. It's just a space where you can kind of just show up and just ask the guys, hey, can we start doing body paint Wednesdays?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, absolutely. You can come in after juggling Tuesdays. Like, and then it was just like that. And we don't have enough of that nowadays. You know what I mean? Like, because the city always shuts it down.
There's no more.
There's codes.
There's no more street dancing in San Francisco.
Yeah, Powell Market, 4th and Market. Look that up.
Every Saturday.
There's no more street dancing. They don't allow it.
It's you have to have you have to get permit. Everything's permanent now in the city. And
you know what? That's one of the things that made San Francisco better than the rest of the big cities. You know what I mean?
The only other city I could think of that isn't like New York.
New York can because they just do it on the subways and they're not allowed to.
Yeah.
Yeah,
they can't get caught because it's so like so busy and all that. Yeah. But like San Francisco is known to be the artistic community, the artistic city. And that was the fucking, this is our bread and butter. This is what made us great.
That's why people moved here. People moved here.
Yeah, shut it all
down. But then like,
flash forward to now, you have, you know, Mayor Lee, letting in, like I said, I don't know. Yeah. Who's the key master? That's the real problem. Who's the key master opening the gate, letting this all in? So, unfortunately,
setting the policy, basically. Just setting the rules.
Exactly. Yeah. What led to the demise of Cell Space is exactly what's currently going on right now in San Francisco and even in the East Bay and further, because it's like a cancer that's
Oakland
spreading.
Is getting fucked too.
So we lost Cell Space due to JP Morgan.
Gentrification.
Gentrification, basically. However, I'm still on a contingent that's fighting to preserve that, because I threw an event, the final Cell Space Jam, spent like half a year playing
that. Look up the documentary. Blah. I think I'm in it.
Yeah, you're in it.
Yay!
I think this guy made it.
I'd be so pissed if he made it and I wasn't fucking in it. I'd be like, we have a podcast, you dick!
I would have been
Here's
like,
an interesting fact.
I'd be like, listen. Some things have to go. The most unintelligent answers.
Oh, hell, what? What?
I'm just kidding. Corn's in it. You're in it.
Corn's in it. Okay. And this is actually the only official documentary of Cell Space. Speaking with prior occupants that used to work at Cell Space, like, you know, your dance group is the only guys that actually made like a documentary, and that's the only documentary. So big props to this guy right here.
Everyone, high five. This, everyone did something.
We're all champions.
Right? We're all champions. Fuck, we're all champions.
I neither made a documentary nor have I won a fucking championship. So.
I'm actually doing a documentary right now. So if you ever see a guy in the camera following me, just act natural.
Can't be in it.
Yeah, you already are.
What? Since when?
Last year.
If I didn't get a fucking...
There's no release form.
This is my life, baby.
It's my life.
But yeah, that's cell space in a nutshell. So the fight's still happening. I'm like on my like Black Panther vibe right now. So you know you're not seeing me post a lot of stuff. It's because now I'm like I'm behind the scenes, kind of like on that working from the shadows.
Nice. Like Batman.
Like Batman. Oh, God. I'm not even worthy. I'm more shit. Damn. Damn.
All right. All right. Listen, Whacko, someone is asking here. Someone is asking you. Anonymous 5411 is asking you, have you ever top rocked to woo a young lady? Now, I will answer this for you.
Oh, thank you.
Because I have a story.
No! Shit! Shit!
So,
wait, before you start, let me go on record by saying, Pat's the only one that can tell this story. And versus, like, I can only tell this one story about Pat, but that's another conversation.
Okay, go.
All right.
Be entertained.
This was when I was a single man. I'm taken, guys.
Unfortunately.
He's with child.
I'm taken. I'm spoken for. Not with corn, goddammit.
Damn it.
No, not with me.
Shit. I know, don't. Please, people, don't write fan fictions about this.
I know you want to, but don't do it.
Look, but
it's tempting, but.
When I was a single man... we were at a club.
Mighty.
A nightclub?
Mighty, yes. A nightclub night called Mighty.
Okay.
Okay, so...
Just want to clarify what the fuck
you... I was, you know, way. Here's the thing. Here's the thing, all right?
He has
like,
a move. He has a setup.
Like, I was trying to dance with this girl, and I had a move. I was dancing by myself, and I would back up, and then I would turn around and be like, Hey!
Shut the fuck up. And then just started move.
Listen. It worked more times than you.
I believe it. I believe it.
So, but the thing is, the setup of this move takes up a long time.
It's like Goku charging.
You know, it takes a while.
Dinky Dama,
you know, because first of all, you're out there, you're trying to prove that you can dance. Mm. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
For starters.
Okay. So, I was dancing, and I had my eye on this lady. And then, I finally get the nerve, man. I do it. I'm like, this is my time. The crescendo of the song is coming. I'm about to back up and turn around. So I do it. I back up. I turn around.
It was Whacko.
And then what do I see? Whacko's dancing with a goddamn girl.
Ah, shit.
And I say, shit, man.
There goes the 20 minutes of me fucking.
There goes
just
all
vibing.
That setup.
Like,
there goes
shit.
It's like fucking. It's like you're. Yeah. It's like I'm preparing a meal, and someone just brings in steak.
I actually wanted the fish.
Leftover House of Prime Rib, you guys.
Yeah. It's like, yeah. Okay. So.
I was making meatloaf.
My story's not done yet.
Oh, it gets better.
What?
So then I go to the drink. I get a bar. At the bar, and I look. And Whacko is making out with this girl.
I'm like,
God damn it. If I only pulled the trigger 2 minutes earlier, if I just turned and been like this, hey.
Hey, hey, oh, wait.
Bang, bang.
Oh, hell, what? Hey.
But anyways, but
oh,
it didn't stop. It didn't stop there.
I was dancing
stop
myself.
It didn't stop there. The rest of the night, I'm like at different places in the club. And then like I look over and fucking Whacko's making out with another girl. A different girl. I was like, wait a minute. I had a setup for 20 minutes, and he's not even trying to get at the girl that he... God damn it.
God damn it.
And then the way it ends, this is how the night ends.
I'll just say this. You guys see the Blade 1, like the bloodbath?
Okay, I'm just going to reenact it really quick. All
right, go.
I'm going to try my best.
Go.
But so,
every
I leave.
Stay in camera.
I leave, and then like I look around, I see the back of Vander's head. Right? That's all I see. And then, like, I see a girl, like, bent over like this. And I just see him going like this. And then, like a fucking hawk, he just looks at me like this. And I was like, oh, God, I gotta go.
No, but
I gotta go.
You left out the strobe light. It was strobing.
Yeah. And there was a strobe light. Fucking, like, so it looked like he was going like this. was like, the fuck? I gotta go. First of all, my move got thwarted. Second of all, I'm in a movie that I don't want to be in.
And my friend's a vampire.
And my friend's a vampire. Oh, I expected your eyes to roll to the back of your head. And I would have been like, ah, ugh.
Oh, shit.
I thought I was going to have to break a bottle and go like this. Dust till dawn. I've seen it.
Saint it.
So anyways, Anonymous 5411, I think I answered your question.
Yeah.
yeah.
Hey.
Getting there.
I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I'm getting there.
I'm taking my time.
So,
Don't take your time too much because I got to pee. So.
Oh, yeah. I got to pee too. Whoa. Hey man, don't cross the streams.
Oh, goodness.
Oh my god.
So I think in a 40-hour vocabulary, what I just told is what we call a war story.
Yeah,
it is a war story, absolutely.
And the only person that could tell it properly is Pat. I love
because
that
I saw it
because he was there
because I experienced so it. I mean,
it was a good night. That was a good night for me.
That's like, the only failure of the move. That's not true. I had like a really weird hit miss ratio with the move.
But how did, yeah.
That's weird because it's a move. I don't know. I've always been like no moves. I just but I like, guess by myself
but
too.
I will say
but
no,
actually
you're
because
no, you're
I'm
no move
drunk.
Is your move.
Yeah, yeah. Because I'd be just drunk and just dancing my because.
I felt extremely bad though, like the following weekend when you told me, like,
hey man,
listen,
I've been building that shit up for like 30 minutes.
I worked hard for that motherfucking shit.
It's like, she
you're my boy.
You didn't say anything.
You know what? We made eye contact a couple of times, but she just made eye contact once with the right guy. So yeah, there you go. Whacko, you have another.
I got questions.
So. What type of dancer do you think makes a great top rocker? Salsa dancer, jazz dancer, hip-hop dancer, swing dancer. Wait, I can answer this. A top rock dancer because top rock is his own dance.
Can I
elaborate? Oh, of course. You're the champ.
Okay. But what if it's not top rocking?
But, okay, let's reframe this question. Okay, so if there was a dancer of another discipline, okay. Which would be... salsa dancer, a jazz dancer, a hip-hop dancer, or a swing dancer, which one of those do you think lends itself best to learning
top
how
rocking.
To top rock or rock?
All of the above, to be honest. I'm about to, like, freak your mind. Honestly, like, okay, so yeah, where
my mind's so freaked right now.
Right? Where I'm at with this, honestly, it's like, you gotta remember, top rock is still a part of breaking, you know? Mm-hmm. So,
right.
When people label me as this top rocker dude, I just kind of smile and acknowledge it. I'm like, okay,
and
that's cool.
You championship belts.
But it's like, I started off as a b-boy. I'm in a locking. I was a popper for a hot second. You know, I learned how to pop.
I remember that.
I actually battled Boogaloo Shrimp in the finals a long time ago before he was dope.
Before he was dope.
Right.
Before he hit a certain power level.
You know, I've been exposed. I did Polynesian dance. I did tap. I've been exposed to a lot of dances. So with that question, it's that's like Ruin is my favorite power mover. I still consider Ruin
is so good.
I still consider Ruin a b-boy, and yep. I'm not gonna like. I think I do him like a disjustice by just denying him that because he's a dope power mover, but he's not a dope b-boy.
Yep.
It's still the same.
I agree because. The whole thing that we were talking about earlier where b-boying is like a huge mentality thing. You know what I mean? Like Ruin changed the game in terms of power moves. Like that dude in what was it? 99, 2000, 2001?
Yeah, because the
like,
first Lords of Four.
That motherfucker was destroying everybody in terms of power moves. Like mm-hmm. He inspired all of Korea. Like, you know what I mean? And Korea is like now they're just
fucking crazy.
Wow.
But
Ruin,
yeah.
but the whole time Ruin was never like.
Yeah, I like.
You know what I mean,
he always
had the mentality.
I mean, me personally, like, I love Ruin. I love Ruin as a dancer. And in my early infancy stages, I was like, man, I kind of want to do a little bit more footwork though, because it kind of sucks when you just get labeled and put into this category.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Oh, you're just a power dude. And like, he's like, okay, he's gonna throw an air flare. He's gonna throw an air flare. So with those categories of dancers you're asking about, honestly, it's the individual. So what do you bring? You know. To this form, like, I mean, does a house dancer have more like soul over a salsa dancer? It's all relative.
I feel like because rocking and b-boying is it's such a dance of just stealing from other dances, right?
Putting in different
spaces. You're just taking influences from other types of music, like whether it's in the dancing, in the creation of the music, all that. Like, you should just do it all.
Yeah.
Fucking, man. Like why not?
Like, jazz is like the one American thing that we can actually claim as Americans. And it's like all about improvisation.
Jazz and hip hop.
Jazz and hip hop.
Jazz and hip hop.
So.
Dude, I'm reading the Miles Davis documentary. Autobiography right now.
Yeah, I'm about to watch the movie this week.
No, I saw the trailer for the docu.
Miles thing.
But, so I bought the fucking autobiography. Holy fuck. Miles Davis is a badass motherfucker.
Dude. We're talking about autobiographies. I'm gonna throw this one out there because I reread it again. Read James Brown, The One. It's way better than the movie. I actually had higher expectations going into watching the movie because I read this book before. But all you real hip hoppers that want to know about James, the real James Brown, James Joe Brown, read James Brown, The One. It's probably the best autobiography ever on James Brown. So
I will read.
But again, Mr. Salsa House Guy,
or girl,
or yeah. Yeah, it honestly, it's like whatever you bring to it. I don't see have one different dance style having one over the other to be
just learn your history. Learn your history. Learn why you're doing it.
I got better as a dancer. Honestly, I learned how to dance with girls.
And that should also answer your
that's
question.
That's an answer your question. That's another thing that I see. Every after party I go to, even when I was overseas, dudes are still ciphering. I was the only cat that was like dancing. I danced with one of the go-go girls that were hired to like entertain us. Like, well, you know, I'm gonna stop there. But
okay.
But yeah, that's where I was.
Another vampire story.
Exactly. Well, yeah.
Okay, I think this is a good question. You have this is a good question to go out on. I think this one.
Are we not going to get all geeky on comics?
We don't have time to get geeky on comics. We're almost out of time. You got to finish that shit up.
Okay, Whacko.
40 hours.
Superman, Batman was whack. That's all I got to say.
Last question. It's a D plus. It's a C minus.
C minus? Okay, I can C minus it.
But, Whacko. Yes. Last question. What is your... This is bad English, but... What is... You know, I'm sorry. I shouldn't be...
Rude. What if it's a non-native English?
I'm sorry.
What if it's our one Guatemalan?
This is a good use of. What is the most ultimate favorite song to top rock to?
God, every time.
What's your fucking jam, dude?
What is it?
Right now, what is it?
See, that's the thing.
Ooh, that's a better question.
Because mood changes. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, you can't listen to the same music all the time. There's no one song that's gonna hype you up forever. Except for Queen, Don't Stop Me Now. That'll hype me up forever.
Don't stop me now. I'm having a good time. Right now, it's for me, it's Exit 9, Fly. One day I woke up thinking as I slipped into my jeans. I knew someday would make it. Yeah, that song. But Exit 9.
There you go. Exit 9.
Exit 9.
Fly.
All right. So I think we're winding down.
Where are you at?
I'm done.
Oh, you're done. So, am I the one? All right.
Wait.
So,
Whacko, do you have anything you would like to plug? Anything you'd like to?
Oh, plug, drop. Yeah.
Please do.
Look for the Whacko tour starting at Massive Monkey Day, April 23rd.
In Seattle.
Okay. I'm gonna be starting a
beautiful
little
city.
Tour. Yeah. And then I'll be hitting up Iceland, Korea, Japan, IBE. I'm coming back. So just be ready.
I'm so glad we're world champions, man.
Me too. It's such an
Top Rock Tuesdays every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday, Top Rock Tuesdays. Yes. It's in San Francisco. Google it. Google it up.
Every Tuesday, Top Rock Tuesday. Comic book quick spill. Sorry. Daredevil season 2. Fucking awesome.
I watched Jonathan Bernthal. Killing it as the Punisher.
Superman
versus
it, buddy. Batman.
Batman versus Superman.
Sorry.
It's like this.
Yo, if we cut out all the Superman parts and just leave Batman, it'd
Bro,
be about right here.
Wonder Woman, why were you in there?
But she was great.
Let's talk about.
I'll just say this. Why didn't Wonder Woman kill Doomsday?
Okay,
that's it. All right, go ahead, Korn.
Thank you, everybody, for fucking tuning in. We absolutely appreciate you. We're going to try to make the production even better now. And we're also going to throw these bad boys onto YouTube. And you can follow us on the channel.
And?
And just hashtag the 40 hour if you have any questions, comments, concerns, just praise, anything. Just send it our way. Follow me at Corn Schismo, CornSkismo. Pat at...
Just don't.
No, he doesn't want to be followed on Instagram, but he likes my picture sometimes, so if you want to follow him through that, that's fine.
Follow Whacko, the Whackness.
The Whackness Instagram. On Instagram. Follow the fucking world tour right here. And we're just happy to be champions, you know? So, thank you guys for tuning in.
Marvel rules, DC, you gotta get your shit together.
I think we should start a new tradition for a new guest. Whacko, why don't you go to the back... And hit the punching bag.
Hit the punching bag.
As Corn, like
I'm gonna do my line. Yeah, I'm gonna do my line.
Once Corn does his line, go ahead and hit the punching bag.
Also, I gotta get up and go.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Go to the back. Fucking Ryu that shit.
Yeah.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much. No, don't put a glove on.
No
glove.
Okay,
no
just get ready. Corn's gonna say it. Go ahead.
Thank you, everybody. Love, peace, and chicken grease.
Go ahead, Bender.